I'm Aris, the Sunfire Gourmet. I became a vegetarian 30 years ago. I was in college during the hippie movement, basically, you know, back to the land in the late 70s. We got to a point where we understood that, you know, the natural food of human being was plant foods. So the more I observed, the more I ate of the fresh vegetarian foods, the more my system just wanted to simplify as much as possible. I was born in Panama. My West Indian family of culinary masters. You know, so growing up in Panama in the Canal Zone, been moving to the U.S. and traveling around the world, I've really been in a position to observe dietary customs, you know. So it's been very interesting just developing myself and then coming to a position where I can share it with others.
What a nice, sunny, bright market day this morning. You know, every time I come to the market, the first thing that always catches my eyes is a nice, young jelly. Because, you know, as I break my fast in the morning, I always like to break it with a jelly. You know, as we say here in Jamaica, you know, the coconut water washes the heart. And there's no better way to wash the heart than with the young jelly coconut water. Now with my coconut, jelly coconut, the first thing I have in the morning, it electrifies the system. And it actually cleanses the system out. So what you're doing when you're drinking a jelly, you're really taking an internal shower. So as you take that external shower in the morning, please don't forget to take the internal shower as well. Oh, it's like drinking milk from the breast of the earth. I tell you, it's always great. And what a big cup. This one, like it, I have a quart of water. So let me see what else is nice in the market. You know, one of my favorite is always the papaya. I love papaya. As a matter of fact, papaya is one of those fruits that you should have with every meal because it's very loaded with digestive enzyme, with papain. And the papain itself, you know, it's the main ingredient in meat tenderizers. So it breaks down protein. And as I eat my papaya, I like to enjoy it with the seeds, you know, because the seeds are magnets. They go into the system and just move everything out. Now my next most favorite food is mango. So we want to have some mangoes for our mango pie. Get a nice variety of some of these golden sunshine red delicious mangoes this morning. And of course, a hard dry coconut for my coconut milk today as well. Excellent source of protein. As we select fruits and vegetables, we always want to go towards the crispest of all. You know, the ones that have the brightest color, the most sunshine, and particularly our greens. You want to get the greens that have the most chlorophyll in it because that is loaded with iron. So I see we have some nice leaf lettuce and some nice romaine lettuce. Oh, this will make a nice salad for me today. And our fruits now with the pineapple, of course, if the pineapples are green, you want to test them to make sure they're ripe by just pulling one of the stems out of the middle, one of the leaves. If it come out easy, you know the pineapple is ripe and ready. So that's all yeah man, love my pineapple so. Look at these nice pears. You get two of them here. You know, pears, it is called avocado because of the color green, the lime avocado green. And in some places we call it pear because of the shape. In other places in the world, they may call it an alligator pear because of the roughness of the skin. But the real original name of the fruit is aguacate. It comes from the ancient Aztec language in Mexico. And aguacate itself means the fruit of water. So here we have our avocado green. A nice fit pear. Guineps. Oh, guineps. Oh yeah. Feel like it's at the height of the guinep season, boy. These guineps are nice. Let me get a nice bundle here. And of course, jackfruit. You can't forget my jackfruit. Yeah. Small piece of this one there. And I always like to taste my jackfruit at the market before I go home with it. Because it always reminds me of the first time I had it when I was in Africa. Mmm. Never fails. Always tastes like the first time. The taste always explodes in your mouth. Mmm. What else we have? A soursop. Soursop make a nice ice cream. We're gonna make a nice soursop ice cream milk here today as well. Now, apples and apples and apples. You know, there's over 5,000 varieties of apples. And these are tropical apples that are from Jamaica. These were actually brought to Jamaica from Tahiti. So here we call them OTT apples. And they make a nice rose light colored tasting juice. And I flavor this with some sugarcane juice to make a nice Tahiti apple wine. And when I choose my apples, I like to get the ones with the darkest, rich color. Let me get a dozen of these nice, lovely ackee here. Now, ackee is a protein dish. And one thing about ackee, you have to make sure that the ackee is ripened on the tree so that the enzyme, the gaseous enzymes that's toxic, has been released. And the ackee, as all of the fruits that come to you with a seed, they can be eaten raw. You know, there's no need to cook ackee. It's been cooked by the sun in a very slow manner. And it is always rich and delicious. Oh yes, pure protein, rich, live protein from the sunshine. Give me a nice bunch of scallion and a bell pepper, one of these suntan bell peppers. You can see the sunshine coming out of it. Now this pepper still needs to ripen up, and as it gets ripe, you're gonna see all the red is gonna be glowing. You love me fresh herbs in my dishes. Them just wake everything up. Rosemary, oh, this is a lovely bunch of rosemary. Let's get a nice small piece right here. They just bring all the dishes to life. Got a cucumber. Got a nice pong of this tomato here. Come on. Just right. You know, coming to the market is such a pleasure. It's such an enjoyable place to be. You know, because the food that we eat, as we know, it is the life force in the food that we're looking for. And when you come to the market and you see all this live food, it just makes you feel alive. You know, and fruits are my favorite. Boy, look at this one. It's the sweet sap. It's in the same family as the sour sap. And I just love it. It just breaks down in your mouth. It tastes so delicious all the time. Give me a nice hand here of some honey bananas. They're always nice and sweet. And of course, you know, there's some beautiful red bananas here today as well. Love it. Let me not overlook these lovely strawberries from the hills. Oh, they look like they've just been picked this morning. This would be nice for my pie today. Get some hot pepper. I like hot food, and there's no better way of heating up your food with a good, sweet, hot Scotch bonnet pepper that is so flavorful. You know, you don't need to have salt and all those other things. This just really stimulates the palate and gets the circulation just moving in the right direction. Passion fruit. Nice essential fruit. This is some cashew seeds. Some nice whole cashew seeds here. I'll make some cashew cheese with this today. Ooh. And you know, what's actually exciting with coconut water is a little lime. Let me squeeze a nice half a lime into my coconut water this morning. Just a little touch of lime. So it makes quite a big difference. Just a little lime in my coconut. So what other veg we have here? Some carrot. think this would really round things out for me this morning. Let me have some melon, maybe a nice cool melon juice this morning. Yeah, a handful of plums for the kids, boys, because we can't come home from the market and pass my neighbors without giving them some plums. I think we better hurry up and move on so we can go and get this food ready for the kids, have the lunch going. Yes, my friend, give thanks, man. You know, one of the things that I really enjoy in life is being in the kitchen, preparing foods, taking care of myself. And I've been having fun doing some really interesting things for you. So the concept that I share with you as the Sunfire Cuisine is how to have fun not cooking. I've been coming from the market with my fresh ingredients for the day. We're gonna make our pie crust. And the pie crust, we're gonna use coconut, the dry coconut. For the pie crust, we're gonna use 1.5 cups of dried coconut. We just chop the coconuts into small pieces. And we're gonna put it in our homogenizer along with almonds. We're gonna use 1.5 cups of almonds with the coconuts into our homogenizer. So we mix both ingredients together. And we process them right into our homogenizer. Okay, we have our ground almonds and coconut. Now to that, we're gonna add a jam. We're gonna make a jam with raisins. We're gonna use 1 cup of raisins right into our food processor with the S blade. And with the cup of raisin, we're gonna use 1 teaspoon of ground cinnamon. Also, we're gonna add some coconut water to this as well. We're gonna use 1/4 cup of coconut water. And we're gonna go ahead and process this. Now we remove the raisin paste from the food processor. And we add it to the ground almonds and coconut. Now this is mixed very thoroughly. And it's always best to do this by hand, so we just add that extra dose of love to it. With the almonds, we need to soak them overnight for a period of 12 hours, as we would do with all seeds and nuts, in order to remove the enzyme inhibitors. Otherwise, we would have to produce digestive enzymes ourselves to break the protein down. And that is a very big job for our body to do. So please remember, always soak all of your seeds and nuts overnight for 12 hours. Now we're gonna roll this dough out. We wanna get a sheet of wax paper and take the dough, put it together. Put it right on the wax paper. And we put another sheet on top of this. Now we're going to use our rolling pin to roll this out. And just very gently, we just roll it in all directions. Now we're using a 9-inch glass pie dish. So we don't want to roll it out too much, just enough so that it would fit right into the pie dish without any excess falling off. We want to remove the top sheet of paper and lift the bottom up with the dough and just place it right onto the pie dish. Now we want to press it right in with our fingers. And as you're pressing it in, you want to just turn the pie dish and keep rotating it all the way around. We want to add the excess to wherever we have a hole. And we use the palm of our hands right on the edge of the dish. And with the index finger of our other hand, we press it right in very gently. and we have our pie shell all ready. Now we're going to put this into the dehydrator, and we're going to set our dehydrator at 125 degrees and just pop it right in. You want to let it be in the dehydrator for approximately 6 hours. And we just want to remove the excess moisture. And we're doing this without destroying the enzyme in the food itself. So at 125 degrees, we will retain the enzymes, and the protein in the nuts will digest itself. Now, as the fun continue, we're going to make a passion sky juice. Of course, we're going to start from the sky with our jelly coconut water. So we want to get the water of one coconut. We want to chop that right open. Put it right into our pitcher here. And along with the coconut water, we're going to juice some sugar cane. We're going to get some nice juicy sugar cane. We'll juice that, and we're going to add to our coconut water 2 cups of sugar cane juice. Just fresh made. Now we're going to also add to that some Tahiti apple. We're going to make the Tahiti apple juice. So we're going to use 2 apples, which we cut into 4 pieces. And we're going to put that right through our juicer so that we can extract the juice. And along with the apples, we're going to also juice some ginger. So we're going to put 1 large thumb of ginger. Large thumb of ginger. Slice that into small pieces. I'm going to run that right through our juice extractor. And you want to add a piece of apple and alternate with a piece of ginger. Juice it right out. Okay, we're going to add the apple juice to our blend here with the sugar cane and coconut water. Also, we're going to add the juice of 1 passion fruit, 1 large fresh passion fruit. You cut it in half, remove the pulp, put it right into a cheese bag, and we're going to press the juice out. Now, along with that, we're going to go ahead and add the pulp from the Tahiti apple juice, so we make sure we extract everything. We get all the essence out of here. And you could just squeeze that by hand with your cheesecloth right into a bowl. Let's use a strainer to make sure that we capture all the pulp. And we're going to add to this the juice of 1 lime. You use 1 nice ripe yellow lime. You juice that by hand in your juice reamer. And we add this right to our mixture here. And this gives us our passion sky juice. Now we're going to go ahead and serve it out. Passion sky juice. Very, very, one of my favorite. Especially with the coconut water that just really just cleanses the system and paves the way for that meal. And we followed that up with an exciting salad. And it's really great fun making salad because the colors, you know, especially, you know, when you just have all these living, vibrant colors, the reds and the golds and greens and whites and everything just harmonize and just create that rainbow. So we had a rainbow salad. We're going to prepare a little vegetable salad, and I have some vegetables already ready here for you. What we're going to be doing is using some romaine lettuce, green leaf lettuce, carrots, cucumber, beets, some golden tomatoes, turnips, and olives, and we're going to put together a tahini dressing to go along with that. First thing we want to do is that we want to shred the carrots up. Now we always peel the carrots. We use a vegetable peeler and peel the carrots so that we remove the bacteria that is in the crevices of the carrots. And we're going to shred it on the meat. We put it right through our food processor through the small feed. Shred it right up. And we're going to transfer it into our salad bowl. And after this, what we're going to do is shred turnips as well. And we're going to use two medium-sized turnips. And this time with the turnips, we're going to put it through the wide feed. And we spread it right down. Same thing, we remove it from the processor and place it right in the bowl, right next to the carrots. And next we're going to shred our beets. We're using one medium beet, and we go right into our large feed with the beets. And we're going to put that right next to our turnips here. We get the nice color vibration here combined together. Now the next step is our cucumber. We're going to get one large cucumber and slice it, cut the ends off. We're going to cut it in half, lay it right onto our cutting board using our chef knife. We're going to slice it in thin slices. If your cucumber is not organic and if it's been waxed, more than likely it's been waxed with carnauba wax, which is car wax, you would want to peel the skin off. But of course we are going to lose some valuable nutrients in peeling the skin, but it's better to peel the skin off if it has the wax and sacrifice that nutrient than to eat the wax, because the wax cannot be broken down in our body at all. Okay, we're gonna add our cucumber right to the dish, right next to the carrots. And the next thing we're going to do is add some green leaf lettuce. So we're going to just break the lettuce, take the bottom and just twist it off. And we're going to just break the lettuce by our hands rather than using the knife, so we won't oxidize the lettuce. Just gently, just pull it apart, small pieces. And we're going to add this one head of green leaf lettuce right to our salad bowl. We're going to create a little space between the carrots and the turnips here for our lettuce. And also, we're gonna use some golden tomatoes. And with the golden tomatoes, we wanna cut two of those. Just cut the ends off. Now what we wanna do here is open up a space between our beets and the turnips. And we're gonna add our slices of golden tomatoes right into our salad bowl. We want to pull off about 6 large leaves of romaine lettuce. And these also, we're going to break those by hand. We always like to use an abundance of light green herbs when we're making our salad. They're very high in moisture and they help to digest the dish much easier. Now to finish off our salad, there's no better crown than some nice, large, juicy black olives. And then after we get this done, we're going to reveal one of our family coveted secrets here and make one of these interesting, exciting dressings. But I do want to let you know that I'm hearing some thunder in the background. Seems like we're having some rain coming in. It's actually that time of the day. You know, we get a beautiful rain here in the afternoon every day. Cool things down right before dinner time. So here we are after the fall. What a beautiful rainfall. It's good to be inside at this moment so we can finish our dish here. We have our salad. Now we're going to complement it with our dressing. We're going to put a half a cup of water. Along with that, we're going to squeeze the juice of a half of lime and add that to our blender. Also, we're going to add a small piece of beets, along with 2 cloves of garlic, about 6 mint leaves, fresh mint leaves, and this all goes right into the blender as well. Small piece of scallion. We're gonna also add some liquid amino, One teaspoon of liquid amino directly into the blender. Also going to add a dash of cumin. And finally, we're going to add some tahini. This is sesame tahini butter. And all we're going to add to this is a quarter cup of sesame tahini. And now it's blending time. We're going to blend it at low speed to begin with. And we're going to turn it up to a high speed. And we just blend for 30 seconds. Now what we're going to do, we're going to put the dressing in a bell pepper. So we have a suntan bell pepper, and cut the top off and cut the seeds right out of it. And we're going to put this right in the middle of our salad here to create our dressing bowl. And this is our tahini rose dressing to complement our rainbow salad. And we're ready to serve. We are the only animals on this planet that actually partake of the milk of other animals. You know, the cows produce their milk for their babies, for the calves, the goats for their babies. But as human beings, we, rather than after weaning, you know, from our mother's milk, we go and take the animal's milk, and especially in the form of cheese, which is very difficult for the body to digest and break down. So I have developed a line of seed cheeses, and the most popular one is the cashew seed cheese. Now the next dish we're going to make is our cashew cheese, and we're going to use the whole cashews. We remove them from the shell, and they're used raw. We do soak the cashews overnight for a period of 12 hours to remove the enzyme inhibitors. We're going to put the cashew through the homogenizer and just break it down into to a paste. Having homogenized the cashews, we're going to add the remaining ingredients. I have already chopped one scallion and a half of a red bell pepper. We're going to add these directly to the bowl. So after adding the bell pepper and the scallion, now we're going to add the juice of two limes. So we juice our limes. And we pour the juice directly onto the cashew with the bell peppers and scallion. And to this, we're also going to add a sprig of rosemary, just a small sprig, about a quarter of a teaspoon of rosemary. This we're going to mince on our cutting board with the knife. Just chop it a little fine. And add it directly to the bowl with the cashews, the bell peppers, lime juice, and scallion. And finally, we're going to add a little liquid amino, one teaspoon of liquid amino, and we mixed. Now, after having mixed the ingredients together, we want to have this sit. You want to have it sit to age, and ideally, you want to have it in an environment of about 80 degrees and let it sit for about 6 hours, and this is where the culturing process takes place. And now the cashew would become a cheese consistency. We're going to mold it into a loaf shape and let it sit for the aging period. Then after that, we're going to put it in a nori roll with other ingredients and turn it into a delectable appetizer. For our entree today, we're going to be doing a seafood dish. And the seafood dish, of course, consists of food from the sea, but naturally not foods that have organs. So we're using plant foods from the sea. We're using sea vegetation as our feature today. So we have three different seaweeds that we'll be combining with our main protein item, which is the ackee. To begin with, we're going to shred celery. We're going to use one half a bunch of celery. And by the way, with the celery, we use the leaves and all, because the leaves is actually the most nutritious part of the celery. It's got more chlorophyll than any other part of the celery itself. We remove the celery from the food processor, place it into our mixing bowl. And the next item we're going to process is our ackee. And the ackee, we have cleaned, removed the seeds, taken out the inner fiber. We're going to put it in the food processor with the S blade this time. And we're going to pulse the ackee. We're just going to just chop it a couple of times so that we can release the digestive enzymes and make it a little tender. We place the ackee in the bowl with the celery. And for the next step, we have already chopped some scallions. This is one bunch of scallion. We're going to add that to the bowl with the ackee and celery. Also, we have diced large tomato. Goes right into the bowl as well. 1 teaspoon of fresh thyme. 3 large cloves of garlic. And the garlic we press. We always press the garlic with our garlic press in order to activate the garlic oil. So we add that directly to the dish as well. Then we're going to marinate our seaweed. We're going to use 1/2 cup of dulse. This is a sea lettuce itself. We want to chop the dulse with our chef knife. We're just going to cut it into small strips. And we'll place it right on our dish right here. Along with 1/4 cup of ijiki. It's another seaweed, a very fine seaweed. And 1/4 cup of wakame seaweed, which has been chopped very fine as well. To these seaweed, we're going to add some liquid. We're going to add a little lime juice. That's 2 tablespoons of lime juice. We'll add a little liquid amino. And that's 1 tablespoon of liquid amino. And we're going to also add 1 tablespoon of olive oil as well. We're going to sprinkle some kelp, which is also another seaweed. This is granulated kelp, right onto the seaweeds that's soaking in the liquids. And also we're going to add a special blend of seasoning. This is a traditional Jamaican cooking seasoning that we're adding here. You could use your favorite spice blend and it will work just as well. Now this gets all tossed together and allowed to sit just for a couple of minutes so the seaweed would absorb all of the liquids. And while that's sitting and absorbing, we're going to mince 1/2 of our medium-sized onion, and we'll slice it down. And we'll cut in the other direction to mince it. Also, we want to warm this up. We like hot entrees. So there's nothing better to warm up a hot entree than with a nice, really, really golden hot Jamaican finger pepper. And we're only going to use 1/4 of this one. This is serious heat here. And we're going to mince that down as well. And we're leaving the seeds in there. It has about 12 seeds in there. And that's where the true heat is. And we add our pepper and onion right to the dish with the other vegetables. We'll toss this all together here. Then we'll finally add our marinated seaweed to this. Mix it thoroughly. And here, as we say, this is what we have as our entree for the day. And again, this is an ackee seafood. And the seafood that we're referring to is an all-plant seafood from the sea, so that those of us who enjoy the taste of fish, we can reminisce with the seaweed, because really the taste of fish that we enjoy is actually the taste of ocean. So the seaweed has the same taste as the ocean, and this weir would give us a nice marinated Escovitch style healthy, very nutritious, and most of all, it is absolutely delicious. Now that our cashew cheese is set, we want to make an appetizer to get our meal started. We're going to use the nori seaweed to wrap it in. We want to get one sheet of nori and a spread of the avocado cheese. We're going to spread it right on the nori sheet, right towards the back end of it, about a third way up. Then to this, we're going to add a couple of slices of avocados, ripe but firm avocados. Besides the avocado, we're also going to add some tomato. One slice tomato. And we have a summer squash, a yellow summer squash, that we are going to add to this. We're going to slice that in half and just lay it right in as well. We're going to spread some ginger slices on here. It's about six slices, very thinly sliced ginger. Then on top of this, we're going to add some pak choi, just fine shredded pak choi leaves. It's about a half a cup of pak choi. This we sprinkle right on top. Now we're going to roll our seaweed sandwich up. This is the nori we have. We're using a sushi mat. And the word sushi in Japanese, it's sandwich. It's the rolling of the particular dish in the nori that is called sushi. We're going to hold the mat and just pull it very tightly. Then we unravel the mat and continue the rolling process here. Now we want to moisten the end of the sheet, so we're going to use a little juice from our fresh sliced tomato just to moisten it here. So this would act as a glue to hold it together, and we continue and finish our rolling up.